Wow, nice shot.
It's a lot easier using a good scope. This one happens to be the Redfield Revolution, manufactured and assembled right here in the United States.
Hey folks, don't go away. When we come back, we're going to take you to the Loophole Factory in Beaverton, Oregon, and we're going to show you the incredible process of how these scopes are made. You know, if you'd like to take a break there, I'd be happy to sit there.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Factory to Field would like to thank our partners. Mothwing Camo, will you adapt? Empire Paintball, the world leader of paintball gear. American Outdoorsman Adventure Club, your adventure awaits. United Country Real Estate, find your freedom. PVA Outdoor Heritage Fund, their sacrifice is our cause.
Today on Factory to Field, we're going to take you to Pagosa Springs, Colorado for the opening of the rifle elk season.
But first, we're heading just west of Portland, Oregon to Leupold & Stevens Incorporated, a well-known and respected manufacturer of binoculars, rangefinders, and of particular interest to us today, the Redfield Revolution Rifle Scope.
The Willamette Valley of Western Oregon is home to 70% of the state's population. Stretching from Eugene to Portland, this fertile valley is always a hop, skip, and a jump away from abundant hunting and fishing opportunities. Oregon is a natural home for well-established outdoor companies like Leupold & Stevens, who have been an Oregon optics manufacturer for over 100 years. In April of 2008, Leupold & Stevens purchased Redfield Scopes, another century-old optics manufacturer that originated in Oregon. Today, Redfield Scopes are produced side by side with their once largest competitor. Same factory, same machines, same employees. Let's go to the factory floor and meet some of those employees and see how the Redfield Revolution line of rifle scopes is made.
We're right now in the factory in the bar stock warehouse. So this is where all the raw material enters the facility and is then routed to various locations on the floor to be manufactured into rifle scopes. Most of our raw material is T6061 aluminum, and it originates with Alcoa, one of the biggest consumers of aluminum in the Northwest. We use about 1 million pounds a year, which is about 5,000 tons. If the aluminum was laid end to end in an extrusion, it would be about 800 or 900 miles long.
Now, that's an impressive amount of raw material. Let's continue through the factory and witness the transformation of raw to revolution. In this process, a pair of CNC machines are using T6061 aluminum to produce the objective bell for the revolution. After the first machine has performed its task, it uses a robotic arm to pass it to the second machine, where another set of operations is applied. Once anodized, these objective bells will be ready for final assembly with other parts that have been simultaneously manufactured all over the factory. But before moving on with scope production, let's head over to where all of the factory's tools are machined to order. Here in the tooling department, Steve Shrewsbury keeps the factory stocked with all of the custom tools it needs to prevent sculpt production from falling behind.
The tooling that we run at this company is specific to the manufacturing of the tooling we need to produce the parts. So to be able to have this tooling built on the outside, it would be very expensive. On top of that, it would take a long lead time to get this tooling in.
This kind of flexibility is not only time and cost effective, but it also encourages and enables frequent product innovation and advancement. Now that we've got the right tools for the job, sculpt production is ready to continue. But first, let's go to Pagosa Springs, Colorado, where anticipation of harvesting a North American elk is running high. Cindy Flanagan and Jerry Holt are gearing up for what they hope will be 3 days of great elk hunting. Unfortunately, the weather forecast is less than ideal. Some snow has started to move in, the fog is thickening, and there is talk of more precipitation. Their first day brought promise through a nice group of cow elk from a distant ridge, but sure enough, the rain started to move in.
I'm wet and I'm cold.
Okay.
So I think we should head on out. And then what do you think? Morning better, maybe?
Absolutely. I think they moved all day and I think they're going to move late tonight because they've already got their full bellies.
Well, let's head out then, and then we'll get a good night's sleep, and then looks like we might get some sunshine tomorrow.
If it comes.
Let's hope.
Yep.
And then they should be out.
Sounds like a
plan. All
right,
thanks, Jerry.
Let's do it.
This portion of Factory to Field is brought to you by All Day Energy. What would you do with more energy?